Hi, my name is Nikita. Thanks for your attention to my presentation and to our work. My name is Nikita Kazarinov, and I would like to present you our work on dynamic fracture of discrete systems. We're a group of researchers from various organizations from St. Petersburg. I personally present two of them. It's State Transport University of St. Petersburg and St. Petersburg State University. So what's the motivation behind our work? We are pretty deep into the dynamic fracture problems in our group, so we decided that it would be interesting to study some basics. By basics I mean some very simple models like linear oscillator, which probably can exhibit some known dynamic fracture effects like fracture delay or dependence of material strength on the loading rate. So if yes, can we use these simple models to address some known experimental data? And also, we're interested in effects which are related and which can be found in systems with discreteness. It's pretty important because such systems actually surround us, for example, layered materials. So are there any effects which are observed in systems like this, which are discrete in their nature? So these are the objectives of our work. My talk can be separated in two parts. The first one is dedicated to the simple model of linear oscillator. We study some effects, some fracture effects, which can be found in this model. And the second part is dedicated to the fracture of chains of linear oscillators and the effects which can be found in these systems comparing to continuous analogs of such systems like elastic rods. So we are going to start with a very simple problem of the linear oscillator. As we all know, probably even from school, that the motion of such system is described by a second order differential equation, which can be easily solved for any type of load applied to the mass. Here we apply a pulse load. We are interested in behavior of such system subjected to a pulse load. And so this is the pulse. It has amplitude A and duration tau. And we apply exhibit fracture condition. The system breaks when the deflection of the mass equals unity. So here is the solution. And we should know that A equaling 1 corresponds to critical static force for such system. I mean, by static force is the system breaks if we have no inertia, if we have just static problem, our spring breaks when force equaling 1 is applied. So firstly, we are going to study dynamic. The first dynamic fracture effect we are going to study is the fracture delay. By delay, I mean the case when the system breaks or the spring breaks after the drop of the load. So here it's the fracture delay, and here when the fracture occurs just at time when the load becomes zero, we call the threshold fracture. So analyzing our solution, we can build dependence of the duration of the pulse on the fracture time t star. You can see that for pulse durations lower than pi by 3, there is no fracture at all. For higher durations, all here is on this slide is discussed for the case of amplitude equaling 1. For higher pulse durations, we have fracture delay. Here, you see, we have fracture delay. And here, in this point, we have a threshold fracture when the fracture time t star equals the pulse duration. And here on the vertical line, we have equal fracture times for all the pulse durations, because just for long pulse, for relatively long pulses, the fracture occurs before the drop of the load. So obviously, even in this simple system, we have an effect of the fracture delay. Here we discuss dependence of the pulse duration on the pulse amplitude. We have three cases here. We have no fracture zone here for the pulses which lie here. The duration and amplitude lie here. We have no fracture. In between two lines, we have fracture with a delay. And above the green line, above the no delay curve, we have a no delay fracture. But actually, all these points, they drop to the green line. So we have a threshold fracture here. So all these curves are also built using the analytic solution we have. And analyzing this solution, we can deduce the following conclusions. Obviously, we have fracture delay effect. We see that very short pulses are not able to fracture the system for a fixed amplitude. We see that there is a minimal fracturing amplitude, which is lower than the critical static force. And we see that for different, for a single amplitude, there are different pulse durations valid to fracture our system. So we have an ambiguity here depending on the case we are working with. We can work with a fracture delay, or we can work with a threshold fracture. So these effects, especially the fracture delay, is known from much more complicated problems from the dynamic fracture mechanics, especially from the area of the crack mechanics. We can read some information on this from the paper by Schocke, Ehrlich, Kalhoff, et Homa about the short pulse fracture mechanics, where they clearly observed fracture delay phenomenon. Now we are switching directly to another effect of the dynamic fracture. It's dependence of the material strength on the loading rate. Here we are going to try to address experiments by Ravitch and Darren Knaus, which are very known among the specialists. They managed to experimentally build dependence of the initial stress intensity factor on the fracture time. So we tried to obtain such dependence using our simple model. We incorporated our linear oscillator model into such problem in the following way. We built an imaginary, like a virtual oscillator in the vicinity of the crack. We cut a virtual mass, like a square of material, and we named it the mass of our oscillator. Then we calculated forces which are applied to our virtual mass using some analytic solutions, asymptotics of the Green's function, and so on and so on. You can read about this in a more detailed way about these solutions in these references. And so we could obtain the linear size D for our mass, for the zone of the material, which is plays the role of the mass. Then we could obtain the stiffness of our virtual oscillator, the critical deflection of the mass from some static strength considerations. The D, if we take D equaling around 5 millimeters, which is almost equal to the plate thickness, we actually are able to obtain very similar results using a very, very simple model. If we solve, we obtain solution for this equation, or where force is calculated according to this formula, then we find the fracture time, and then we calculate the corresponding value of the stress intensity factor. And we can easily get a very good feed of experimental data by our calculation results. Actually, we also managed to almost managed to model the fracture delay phenomenon, but it's work in progress, and I hope that we will manage to publish it in the paper for this conference, or probably earlier. We shall see how it goes on. Now we are switching to a more complicated problem, which describes fracture of discrete systems with some period. But we are going to start with a continuous problem. Let's consider an inelastic rod, which is pre-stressed and which is suddenly released. As we know, an elastic release wave will start to propagate along the rod, and no fracture will occur. It is very natural for us that if a release wave will not cause any fracture. But if we consider a discrete analog of our rod problem, a chain of linear oscillators with arbitrary number of links, we solve this problem for a pre-stressed chain. We write a system of differential equations, we solve it, we find the eigenvalues of our stiffness matrix, we find eigenvectors, we find constants, and finally we obtain the solution. And if we build a deformation, the solution for the deformation of the first link, which is linked to the wall, we see that the release wave may cause fracture of this link. While in the rod, with the continuous analog of the discrete chain, there is no fracture at all. So, we see that in a continuous problem, in a continuous formulation, there is no fracture. But in a system with discreteness, there is evidently fracture. So, this is an effect which does not disappear if we take more links. It doesn't disappear with a limit. So probably this effect should be taken into account when structures with explicit discreteness are designed. We also conducted the same research for another statement of a problem when our chain of oscillators is loaded with some force applied to the last mass. This problem is also described by a system of differential equations which can be solved explicitly, analytically, for example, for a pulse load. Again, we solved it analytically using some tricks which are similar to Duhamel's method, but for a system of differential equations. We get this solution for the deformation of any link in our chain. It's a bit scary, but we can use it. It's useful. And again, we see that the pulse propagating through the chain is distorted, and this distortion may actually cause fracture of the link. While in a continuous problem, it is not possible. The traveling pulse is not distorted, and no fracture occurs. So again, we see a difference here between two systems: a continuous system, an elastic rod, and a discrete analog of this system, a chain of oscillators. So this leads us to the conclusions of our work. They also contain two parts. The first part is the part regarding the single linear oscillator. We discussed some dynamic fracture effects using such a simple model. And we also managed to at least qualitatively describe some experimental data using such a simple linear oscillator model. In the second part, we discussed a more complicated systems, mainly chains of linear oscillators, and we've shown that in such systems there may be fracture effects which are not possible in continuous systems such as elastic rods, and probably such effects should be taken into account when materials or structures with explicit discreteness are designed. So thank you for your attention. Thank you for listening to my presentation. And if you are interested in such topics, please feel free to contact me. Here is again the email on the first slide. You can write me anytime. And I hope to see you in real life, probably in ECF 23.